talking about this world. This world up
that's
here.
That's what I am asking.
So that you have a problem.
Don't. This problem is what?
You have a problem with this. If you think you believe that there's different Qurans.
I don't have a problem. I do have a physical evidence that there are different Arabic Qurans. I do expect people like this gentleman who is Muslim to have a problem.
Do you speak Hebrew? Do you read Hebrew? The same can be said of the Bible, though, can't it? The Bible's been translated from a language other than English. Exactly the same.
No, it's not exactly the same. There are not many different Bibles. So let me put it together. You told me that Japanese scientists, which I'm really not aware of.
See, sorry, it's too tall for me, man.
I can give you
okay.
Google, and then you can just Google them and get the name of them.
I have a phone, but
okay. Do you mind just giving me the name?
I'm sorry. What's your name,
sir? Together we can all go. So you gave me the name of the Japanese scientist who you expressed that he looked at the Quran and then he came to the conclusion that there is no difference in that. So as a Christian, my stand is we do have many actually in England we are very privileged. We do have many different translations of the Bible. If you go to the certain part of the world, they haven't even got the translation yet.
That means
because there are lots of things being translated, there are lots of different languages. So none of the Christians would make a claim that Bible, dot by dot, letter by letter, sound by sound is exactly the same. People don't make such a claim because it is written by human beings. We would make a claim that we do have eternal word of God, Lord Jesus Christ, who is perfect. Bible is written by human beings. When you look at the manuscripts, you get to see, because it is written by human beings, and earliest manuscripts were written under the persecution. Therefore, you get to see there are textual variations in it. And then we study that. So I don't make that claim.
Do you think that would affect your faith?
No, I looked into the manuscripts. I looked into the manuscripts until 7th century. There is nothing affects my faith. So now,
I can't find it.
Why can't you find it?
Because I've got thousands and thousands and thousands of stuff on my phone, and I haven't even had time for the information to go through. I can send it to you. I can find it when
I'm here. I'm here every Sunday, unless my speaker's gone is off. I would love to get the name of the Japanese scientist who makes a claim that there is one Quran and there are not changes in it. So now, let me show you the two physical evidence, and then also I'll show you the clips from your Muslim scholars. And is this Japanese scientist?
This is a very.
Muslim?
I'll be. No, it's not. So, it's impartial.
Okay, non-Muslim, not. So you need to make a choice, believing in making a decision between two different Arabic Qurans, which you will see, and also choosing your own Muslim scholar versus putting your Islamic tradition and Muslim scholars under the bus and following a Japanese scientist. That's the decision you will have to make. But let me show you the example.
How do you make your decision which
let me show you the example.
I don't know.
So would you agree with me? There is a difference in Arabic and in English. I might need help some English speakers here. Difference between children, okay, and son. Children and children versus son. Yeah. There is a difference. What is the difference?
Well, you can be a 50-year-old son. You can't be a 50-year-old child.
Or you can be children and girl, but you wouldn't be son. Okay? So if you have the Quran, which one Quran says children, other Quran says the son, would you say there are different?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So you don't read the Arabic, but you are from Britain?
Yes.
Do you follow the Hafs Quran?
What's that?
Do you follow the Hafs Quran? Which Quran do you follow?
What's the one I read?
Pictel is the translation, but which different Quran has been used to translate the Pictel? You don't know. Okay, I'll go with Hafs because majority of Muslims in Britain follow the Hafs Quran. This is the Hafs Quran.
Hafs is H-A-L-F-S.
H-A-F-S.
Alright, okay.
So this is Hafs Quran, okay, Arabic is Hafs Quran, translated by Muslim scholar Yusuf Ali, okay? And this is Khalat Quran, okay? It is written, as you can see. So it is all Arabic, okay, put together by Muslims. So Surah 43 verse 81 is the verse I want us to look at. Say, if Most Gracious had a son, I would be first to worship. Okay, that's the English translation.
If Allah Most Gracious had a son, I would be first to worship.
Okay. Okay. Yes. So, since you said you don't understand Arabic, okay, I'm going to show you the visual and then I will expect you to go home and do your homework. Okay? Don't take what I'm saying. I can read, but I don't understand. Okay? So, if you look at this word underline, you've got wa, number 9, okay, and then you've got elif here, okay, and then look at the top of those letters, okay, just I'm just showing these three underlined words, okay, and then in here, in here I've got the same word, okay, you've got letter number 9, you've got elif, and then it goes on, okay, look at the top of it, one of them has line, one of them has line, okay, this one doesn't have the line, this is different. That's different. Okay, so from son it changed to child.
Right.
Okay, that's first of all. Would you say there is a difference between Allah and Muhammad?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Absolutely. Okay, so let me show you another example. So that was Surah 42, verse 81. I would expect you to check it and then we talk about it next time. So Surah 27, verse 12. And then also I'm going to show it to you what Muslim scholars write it, okay? So Surah 37 verse 12, this is the word I am looking at it, okay? In here it says, I am amazed. Okay, Allah is speaking, Allah is the one who is amazed.
I am an amazed.
I am amazed, yes.
I am in amazement, right.
Okay, the Allah is speaking.
Yeah.
Do you mind holding this like this so we can compare? Okay. And then in here, it is you amazed. So Muhammad. This one is says Allah is amazed. In this one is you amazed. So Allah and Muhammad are different. Is Allah amazed or is Muhammad amazed? Okay, those. It is hard to say, but so there are.
But also, that the word thou. He's speaking about Allah. We can't assume that he's speaking.
No, Quran is the speech of Allah. Allah is that. So Allah is speaking in this one. In this one, Allah is speaking. In this one, Allah is telling Muhammad that you are amazed. So that makes two different Qurans. Okay, and I show you two different examples. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you the book which was put together this year by a Muslim scholar who looks at the 30 different Arabic Qurans, and then he puts together the differences. So I'll tell you first of all.
Has anyone done the same exercise with Bible?
Yes, yes. There are websites that you can go and check it. You can look at the variations. We do have 5,856 Greek manuscripts, and then there are many variations between them. But I never come to Speakers Corner and then say, oh, Japanese scientists told me that there are. That is.
For every argument, you can find someone that's going to give you something to look
at. So, your Muslim scholars are telling you that there are different Arabic words. Let me give you an example, okay?
I don't see the point.
You don't see the point.
Yeah.
Your brain believes there is only one Quran. You don't believe there is only one.
No, I believe in the Quran, and I believe
which
that
do you believe?
Again, I believe there are different, very subtle transliterations.
I'm not talking about the transliterations. I'm talking about Arabic.
Yeah.
Okay? Even that, but, so, do you believe there are different Arabic Qurans?
It would appear so, yes. Do you believe there are different Bibles?
No.
Does it change your faith?
No.
Does it change the message greatly?
No. But for you, yes. For you, yes.
I don't. No, you believe.
I already showed you the examples, and I'm going to show you more examples. So, and I don't make the claims you are making. Okay, so here's the list.
How are we going to get some sleep grinning holes in the
website? That was yeah, that's what I was explaining. Okay, so, Sheikh Yasin Kadhi expressed that there are holes in the narrative when you look at it, there's 37 different narrative points.
Right, so you've made a metaphorical statement.
No, I did ask Muslims, explain it to me why there are different narrative points. Yeah. Muslims didn't explain it to me, and then I made it visual for Muslims to kind of be brave enough and then tell me why for centuries they've been lying to Muslims and telling Muslims that there is only one perfect preserved Quran. And even the gentleman over there, he's been screaming that Quran is miracle and it never changed. There is only one Quran. Yet I showed him three different Qurans, all he did was walking away. So maybe in England you are privileged. Are you British? Yeah. So in England you are privileged. You are not to be British and then you
several countries made up into one, whereas we come from England, so it makes us into one. Okay. If you come from Scotland, it's Scotland.
Okay. I'm not going to go through that.
Where are you from?
I'm Turkish. So in here, you've got the privilege of critical thinking and even going to check Google and finding the different Arabic Qurans because they are all over the internet. But in Muslim world, people don't have access to those information. People are not as much critical thinking as you are. Therefore, they take what they check has been telling them, and they Sheikhs are telling Muslims that there is only one Quran, don't fight those letter by letter, it's perfectly preserved, even to the sun. So therefore, Muslims believe what their Sheikhs are saying, and they stuck in Islam. So foundation of Islam is based on the Quran and Muhammad. So far, 37 Qurans caused Islam to mess up. Alongside of that, you do have actions and characters of Muhammad, very much disturbing.
So I'd never do what a man tells me. I would never listen to the scholar or the imam or the priest. Or, I don't do what they tell me.
Do your own research?
I do what I get from that.
Get from what?
From your book.
From the Quran.
What I read and what I take feel in my heart and what I understand of it, that is what I follow.
Does Islam give you that chance?
Sorry,
what's your name? Does Islam give you that right to just read it and use your own interpretation?
Yeah, of course.
You?
Yeah.
Okay. So, can you, in that case, be kind British and English, explain it to me, Surah 65, verse 4? That's okay, I've got English translation. Sign international? We can pick up picture translation if you want, so that we don't get confused. Because I'm gonna make a case. Sorry. I'm gonna make a case. Actually, Islam doesn't give you right to read it and then put your own interpretation. But first, I let you do your own interpretation and then explain it. Sahih International, okay? Still can you go to Pictou one? Pictou translation, Surah 65, verse 4.
65,
verse 4.
Moses spared the menstruation among young women. If you doubt in their waiting period, it is extremely important. The ones who not menstruate are men, and those who are pregnant, until they are their servants and whoever fears Allah.
I read the translation and then I will ask you to explain it. And those who no longer expect menstruation among your women, if you doubt, their waiting period is 3 months. Okay, so there are women who are not bleeding anymore. When you divorce them, you give them 3 months to figure out if they are pregnant or not. Okay? And for those who have not menstruated, so who are those people?
No. I'm not menstruated.
Where did you come to the conclusion it's talking about men?
Well, men.
No, it doesn't say men.
Okay, it could be though. This means it's, yeah. I'm assuming you mean
What does that mean?
Girls that have not met come to maturity.
Girls who are not believing yet. Okay? So, what will because you told girls who are not believing yet.
Wait.
Sorry?
Wait.
No. You have to when you divorce them, this is talking on the context of divorce.
Yeah.
Okay, when you divorce them, you give them waiting period of 3 months to figure out if they are pregnant or not. So for you to divorce someone, if this occasion is the children who are not believing yet.
Yeah, okay. So can you divorce? Because somewhere in their stress, they don't measure.
Okay. So, sick, just before you understood that this verse is talking about the divorce,
yeah,
you were talking about the girls and the children, yeah, okay? So, let's first take the example of children.
From a leading question.
Yeah.
From a leading question.
Okay. Let me just first focus on this. For you to divorce these children, okay? What do you do before divorce? What is the label of that act?
Before you get divorced?
Yes. What is your relationship with someone?
Yeah, you have to have a sexual relationship.
What is the label of that? What is the label of that? So, you are marrying with someone and you are having sex with someone.
Yeah,
and then even... According to who? According to who?
They have it, they're not a woman.
According to who? According to who? But in here, it tells you you are divorcing children and that you are giving them 3 months of waiting period. So what are you... No, I'm not tricking you. So I am asking, you said...
Sometimes don't mention it.
Okay. Tell me, how did you understand in this context, it is talking about those words?
At the first glance.
So, at the first it is appearing as a children,
yeah,
but now you understood the context and you see it's disturbing. Just a moment. You saw it's disturbing and then you want to push in the lines of maybe like someone who is ill, okay?
Yeah. If they're disturbing, while we're there, let me digress. If there is no difference in Islam, have sex with a woman or a child, why the need in that verse to identify them separately?
I'm going to come to that.
So there must be further context.
I'm going to come to that. Yeah. So, so far, your own interpretation is not enough for yourself. So where do you go?
It's not,
Quran is not for thinkers.
No.
You said you can read the Quran and then you interpret by yourself. Okay? So you can't do that. So far, your own interpretation is telling you you are having sex with children and divorcing those children, and that is very much ugly.
No, he did the same thing with that.
He did. He already interpreted that, and then he already did, and he knows that it's very much ugly. No, just a moment. That is his own interpretation. But your own interpretation. Now, in your own interpretation, there is a problem. So where you go to? You go to the interpretations already put together by Muslim scholars, early Muslim scholars. Have you heard something called tafsir?
Within myself, I know I wouldn't have sexual relationship or marry a child.
Why? Why? What is the reason for? No man would... Okay, that are we telling Muhammad was not right in mind when he had sex with a child?
Well, she was menstruating, clearly.
According to who?
She would have been a woman.
No, according to who?
The practices of
Islam. Where? Give me one Islamic source.
You give me a source that says...
Give me one Islamic source. How old was Aisha?
Between 9 and 11.
Yeah.
No, she's not between 9 and 11.
Yeah. Tell her to read a verse in the Bible where Noah slept with his daughters. Can you read that verse for me? As Muslims, you don't believe that.
I am happy to read that verse, but first I want you to tell me, why if you identify your prophet is not man in right mind, why do you follow him? I don't think that is funny. But you just told me, as a man who is in right mind, you wouldn't have sex with a child. Just a moment.
But it also takes...
You wouldn't have sex with a child, and someone is having sex with a child. You told them not to try in mind, but you are quite okay with your prophet to do so.
Maybe different, right?
So what was the difference between child who was 9 years old, 6 years old, apparently, and then, according to her testimony, she was 6 years old when she married Mohammed, and then Mohammed had sex with her when she was 9. In that occasion, Mohammed was 54. So, how old are you? 40. Mohammed is older than you.
I'm not looking for children.
I hope you didn't think I was 54
then. No. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm clearly over 50. Nothing personal, but he's over 50. Do you think what kind of body shape did Aisha had in her age as a 6 years old while playing with the doll? So you don't agree with Aisha?
I don't agree with the age of 6.
So Aisha tells she was 6 years old.
Can you prove it? I've never found that. I've never found that.
You never found that. So have you read any Islamic sources?
Some.
Okay, I'll show you some Islamic
sources. We asked why there was holes in the Quran.
No Muslim would ever do that
to a Bible.
Oh, well, Muslims think it's all right to chop people's head off, so that's worse.
Yeah, but so do Christians.
No, sir. You're not better than me, that's a point.
Well, really? What about all the guillotines that were built and the beheadings in times of what?
I don't think I'm better than you either.
Sorry?
I don't think I'm better than you.
I am a sinner, and I believe you are a sinner, and you are on the wrong path. So, write down the references. Can you write down the references for you to go home and check it? Yes, this gentleman is already going to check a couple of references.
It's fine. People don't mature these days until they're a lot older.
So now you are trying to justify that, but first let's focus on.
It is a fact. You have to stay in education.
Sir, I'll finish. When I finish the gentleman, I'll talk to you. I will finish the gentleman and then I'll talk to you.
As a woman.
Sir,
sometimes
I will finish the gentleman. Once I finish with the gentleman, I'll talk to you. Okay?
Yeah, that's what I say. Stress and stuff.
You
see what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you need to justify that versus communicating that. I will justify.
Can you assure that it means what you mean?
Yes. I will bring today Islamic sources to you. Go to Ibn Kathir, Ibn Abbas, Al Jamalayan, they already tell you that group is young age. If you want, I can read it here. It just came up. You've got Ibn Kathir, and then Ibn Kathir states, the same for the young who have not reached the years of menstruation. Jalalayan. Also those who have not menstruated because of their young age. Basic Islamic sources. If he's a Muslim.
You ask him at the beginning, then would you follow the Kathir only? If he says yes, then you read this.
I didn't ask that.
You see what I mean?
I didn't ask that.
No, you ask him, can you read or understand it? Then you have your own understanding of it.
That's what he said.
He said yes.
Yeah, so
and then why you force this interpretation?
I am not forcing,
because it matches your agenda.
Sir, no. This is your most reliable Islamic tradition.
Listen, have to be,
if you don't trust
have to be
it,
logical.
Just throw it under the bus.
The most reliable.
Just throw
from
it
where
under
you get
the
it's most reliable.
Throw it under the bus.
The most reliable for us is Quran. Where did you get this from?
Oh, and your Quran.
I can get your book from a man, you know, like written like, I don't know, like 600
your
years ago. That means
it
doesn't. I mean, you can't prove it. You just say it.
No, sir, I'll give you the reference. If you are shocked.
Exactly.
Where did he get the information? I agree.
You have a serious passion to disprove something.
Is that his fault?
So why care?
Why don't you preach Christianity instead of just trying to prove that Islam is wrong?
Sir,
show me a piece in your religion. That's basically
it. No.
Well, humans, you know, we use our logic.
Let me first state something. I am very passionate to disprove Islam because I strongly believe it is a very dangerous ideology.
How?
As an ideology. How? Okay? You are not even allowing me to finish. So just calm down. I know your ideology just proved that this is all right. I have 60 children.
Are you attacking?
And then you are already upset about it. Smoking kills.
I do know. It's haram.
It kills.
I will repent.
Before haram, it is kills. It makes you suffer.
But you know that you don't get consensus in Mexico, a Christian country. You get vowed Christian.
Where did you get the information that smoking is all right or all those things?
No, I didn't. I know the smoking is wrong.
Islam is very much dangerous ideology to humanity. Examples is, you look at the life of Muhammad and then you see his actions. You look at the Quran, you see how much Quran teaches about me as non-Muslim, and then the teachings of that, it is very much dangerous to me. I am called, Allah doesn't even know my favorite color, but Allah calls me because of my belief, verse of creation. Allah calls me to be killed if I don't pay the money to the Islamic government.
Can you prove that happened somewhere?
Surah 98 verse 6, sir. Surah 9 verse 29.
Says you should be killed because of what, sir?
Surah 9 verse 29.
And what do you believe that says? That you should be killed?
If I'm not going to pay the money called jizya, right. That's not a tax on anything, you pay the government to protect you from Muslims, then I should be killed. Okay, that's it. Surah 98. Surah 98. It is not. Quran is not for that place. If it is for that place, you need to tell me. Quran is not. Quran is just for that place.
Yes.
Quran is the eternal word of
Allah.
Allah planned that from eternity beginning to eternity end. From eternity beginning to eternity end, Allah could last in the heart of Muhammad so he can be saved with his daughter-in-law. From eternity beginning, Allah could last in the heart of Muhammad, he can have sex with a child. From eternity beginning, Allah planned, I am the first of creatures.
I know we've gone off to some enormous tangent. It was just why you drove
up. Would you be coming up and then next week bring the Japanese?
I will. No, I'll email you because I live in Harwich. I'll come back and trip down. I'll take you tomorrow. It's about an hour away.
So I live far.
Where's that? Where do you live?
I live 146 miles far from here. I'm here every Sunday. Yeah. Nice to bring you the rapper.